Welcome to the testing world. So in previous session we have seen how we can go for condition handling in JavaScript by using if and else. Now I'll cover one scenario in which we are going to have multiple conditions and we are going to use if, else if, else. So I'm moving to my notepad++ and creating a new file. I'm saving this file first. And this saving is not mandatory actually. You can write your code and only after that save it. But I'm saving it before writing the code, and later on whenever I'm going to make any changes, I'm just going to do Control S. So here I'm writing a code, and here before writing the code, I'm saving it with the name condition2. So my file is saved with condition2.js. And this time I have a different scenario. So scenario is, I'm writing a multi-line comment here. We have a number, and we need to check following condition. So we need to check following conditions. First, check if number is negative, display negative number. Second condition we need to check, if number is 0, then display it's 0. Third condition, number is positive, then check it's even or odd. So it's a very straightforward question where we are checking more than two conditions. Here, first of all, I want to declare a variable. So I'm writing like input number, and I'm giving the value like, first of all, I'm taking negative number. So we'll test all the number. As of now, I'm just giving input, which is -1. Here, if my first condition is that, if my input number is less than 0, then I'm writing like console dot log, and I'm saying this is negative number. So that's my first condition. Now first condition is satisfied, where if the number is negative, then display negative number. Second condition is, if the number is 0, then display 0, and then even or odd. So here we have more than two conditions. If we have only two conditions, then if and else. But if we have more than two conditions, we can use if, then else if. Here I'm defining second condition. So else if the input number is 0. So I'm writing double equal to 0. If the input number is double equal to 0, means console dot log, and I'm saying this is 0. So here first condition will always be placed in if, then any number of conditions you can place in else if. So that's a first condition, that's a second condition. I have one more condition, so again else if. Third condition is that if the number is not negative, not 0, it means number is positive. And if the number is positive, I need to check even or odd. So if the number is not negative, not 0, means number is positive. And now I'm checking input number. If the number is positive, then I'll mod it by 2 and the answer is 0. Now it means it's a even number. So what I'm saying, console dot log, and this is even number. So here we have covered three conditions, and first condition in if, then else if, then else if. But you can write else if any number of time, and at the end, if the number is not negative, not 0, not even, means it's an odd number. So I'm using at the end else, and I'm writing like console dot log. This is odd number. Here we have covered all the four conditions. First, if, then else if, and at the end, else. I'm just going to execute this. So for execution, I'm moving to command prompt. We know that how we can execute this. So I'm executing condition2.js this time. Enter. We are getting this is negative number. Why we are getting negative number? Just because a number is passed minus 1. So that's a negative number. Now, I pass a different number. Here I'm setting 0. Clear screen. Running it again. Answer is 0. Why 0? Because here number is 0. First condition is not satisfied. It is moving to the second condition. It is satisfied. So it's display. This is 0. I'm changing the number. I have checked negative and 0. This time I'm changing it to the 11. Running it. Answer is odd number. Why? It's not negative. So this condition is not satisfied. Not 0. This is not satisfied. Mod by 2 and we are not getting 0. This is not satisfied. At the end, it is going to the else. So we are getting this is odd number. And if we pass like 112, so this time we should get answer. This is even number. Again, not satisfied, not satisfied. Here it is satisfied. Here our condition is true. So we have seen here we perform more than two conditions, or we are checking more than two conditions. One thing I want to explain here. First, we have checked this condition, second, third. Here we also check one condition like if input number mod by 2 and answer is 1. If I mod a number by the 2 and we are getting answer is 1, this is the odd number. This condition is also perfect. So what we are doing, here I'm not writing else. I'm handling all the condition in if and else if. If I try to execute this, you will notice it will execute perfectly. Why perfectly? Because it's not mandatory to write else. First condition is if, all other condition are in else if. Because we have covered all the conditions in if and else if, so it's not mandatory to use else. So here, if you notice, it will work perfectly for all inputs. One more update I want to give it over here. For that, what I'm going to do, I'm placing this third condition on the first place. Means logic will be same, just changing the order of the condition. So first I'm checking even, and on the third number I'm checking for negative. So I'm making this change like this is negative number. So still we have all four conditions which we are checking. First for even, then for zero, then for negative, and then for odd. All the four conditions we are having. Now question is, do you think still my logic is correct or not? So let's try our logic is correct or not. So here what I'm doing, first of all, I'm testing with the 112. Okay, answer is even. That's perfect. Okay, I'm testing with 111. Answer should be odd. Okay, we are getting correct output. Okay, let's try with 0. We are getting even number. Why? Because if you notice, in the case of 0, first it will come to the first condition. And here if 0 mod by 2, answer is 0. And it is showing even number. But what was the question? If the number is 0, then display 0. Point over here is, we are writing multiple conditions and we are covering all the conditions. That's perfect. But ordering of these conditions also matter, because whenever we are running, first it go to the if. If this is not true, then it is going to the second condition. If it is not true, then it's going to the third condition. Here if you take the example of 0, it is true in the first case. So here it shows even, it's not going to the rest of the conditions. So again, When we are writing multiple conditions, we just need to check with the different inputs, my condition is working perfectly or not. Because you just seen here, I'm just changing the order of the condition and my logic is failing. So here we have seen how we can go for the multiple conditions by using if. Anytime we can use else if and at the end else. That's all we have for this session. Thanks for watching this video.